Introducing Cluster Control, your ultimate tool for orchestrating database ops at scale while maintaining full control over your data stack, whether on-prem, in the cloud, or across hybrid environments. Cluster Control offers powerful features built for DevOps teams. In this demo, we'll cover deployment, scaling, observability, comprehensive monitoring and alerting, high availability and failover, backup and recovery, and database version upgrades. Whether you're a novice or an expert, Cluster Control enhances your database management capabilities, enabling you to focus on value-creating motions rather than manual, time-consuming maintenance. Let's start by exploring how Cluster Control performs hybrid deployments. Take the guesswork out of deployment for your DevOps teams with easy-to-set-up solutions that minimize human error and avoid time-consuming experimentation with open-source utilities. With Cluster Control, you can deploy databases across any environment and region with just a few clicks. This helps mitigate vendor and environment lock-in and gives you the freedom to administer databases across on-prem and cloud environments. In this demonstration, we have deployed our Cluster Control instance on an AWS EC2 instance. Meanwhile, we'll be deploying a MySQL Galera cluster with nodes distributed across three different environments, one on-prem, another on DigitalOcean, and the third on GCP. We have already set up secure, passwordless SSH connectivity between Cluster Control and each of these environments with the help of VPN. To begin, on the dashboard click Deploy a Cluster.
Here, you can also choose to import an existing database into Cluster Control.
Next, select the type of database you want to deploy. Cluster Control supports a variety of database flavors and license types, including enterprise versions of MongoDB and Postgres. As mentioned, we'll use MySQL Galera provided by Percona ExtraDB version 8.0. Click Continue, name the cluster Sovereign Galera Cluster, and assign it the tag Multi-ENV. Next, set up the SSH credentials. The SSH user for this Cluster Control environment is root. You can choose to disable the MySQL software installation process and other security configurations if necessary. Proceed to the specific node configurations. The default settings are provided, so we only need to set the password for the root user and move to the next step. Adding nodes to the cluster is also very easy with Cluster Control. Simply enter the IP address or host name of each node from the on-prem, DigitalOcean, and GCP environments.
Each node takes about 20 to 30 seconds depending on your connectivity. So I'm going to fast forward this process, but this is how it'll look.
Once you've entered the node's IP addresses, Cluster Control will add them to the cluster. You can hover over the info icon on each node to quickly view details such as CPU, memory, and operating system. Finally, preview the cluster details and click Finish. Cluster Control will deploy the cluster, install all necessary software, and configure each node accordingly. It's as easy as that.
This part will take a few minutes. I've sped up the footage. Please note that the UI will keep you updated.
Cluster Control's point-and-click interface enables your team to flexibly scale clusters using load balancers and node actions. It helps you avoid over-provisioning by shaping your cluster to meet your evolving needs, adding or removing nodes as necessary. This means you can easily adjust your database infrastructure to accommodate changing workloads, ensuring consistent performance and reliability. For DevOps teams, this translates to faster deployments, reduced operational complexity, and enhanced agility in managing database environments. In our deployment overview, we initially set up a multi-primary Galera cluster. Now, within the same Cluster Control environment, we also have an existing MariaDB replication cluster with one writable primary node, which we'll use to demonstrate how to add secondary nodes. To add new nodes to the cluster, click on the action menu on the right, which provides a drop-down list of actions you can perform on the cluster. Hover on Add New, and select Replica Node. Here, you can choose to either create a new replication node or import an existing one. For this demo, we will create a new node. Next, configure the node. Clustercontrol has pre-filled the default configuration, including the MySQL port 3306 and the Netcat port ranges. The Netcat port is used to stream data to the replica node. Next is the advanced settings. Note that you can toggle off and on other options if desired. Select the cluster's primary node, then add the IP address or host name of the new replica node. Wait a moment for cluster control to establish the connection. After the connection is established, click Continue to preview the configuration, and then Finish to submit the creation job. You'll see that Cluster Control is creating the replication node from the job you just submitted. After a few minutes, the replica node will be up and running. This process is similar for adding a node to your database cluster of any flavor. Once the replica node is done creating, we will be able to see the node in the node list, and also the cluster topology. If you remember earlier on in this demo, there was only one primary node. Now there is a replica node, and the primary node is streaming data to the replica node. The replica node is read-only, whilst the primary node is writable. Next, we'll cover observability. DevOps teams often struggle with monitoring cluster health and performance, requiring advanced tools and expertise. Diagnosing and troubleshooting issues can be particularly challenging in distributed, multi-cloud, or hybrid environments. Clustercontrol's agent-based monitoring using Prometheus simplifies database observability. It provides a unified view for all deployed database clusters and nodes, ensuring no aspect of your environment is overlooked. Its straightforward overview page and dashboards, including system, cluster, and database flavor, specific overviews, enable quick issue identification and resolution with real-time alerts. The logs tab displays system and audit logs for specific clusters. System logs provide a tree view of corresponding database logs across a cluster. Clicking on a log file will reveal that log in a new tab in the viewing panel to the right. Browsing through the appropriate error logs is a key element of a troubleshooting process. Clicking on Refresh Logs will trigger a job for cluster control to perform log collection. By default, the logs are fetched every 30 minutes. Audit logs show records of cluster control's events and changes carried out by a user. As you can see, the collect logs action that I performed a few seconds ago. Beyond logs, Cluster Control allows you to manage notifications and alerts across all components of your architecture, including servers, networks, and load balancers. For instance, if Cluster Control notifies you that you have a long-running query in your cluster, you can click on the alert to view the specific server and also a recommendation to resolve the issue. Another key feature of Cluster Control is its advisors. These advisors provide specific advice on addressing issues in areas such as performance, security, log management, configuration, and storage space. Advisors can range from simple configuration advice and threshold warnings to more complex rules for predictions or cluster-wide orchestration tasks based on the state of your servers or databases. The Activity Center offers a single view of logs and alerts for all database clusters managed by Cluster Control, enabling you to gain comprehensive insights into your cluster health and performance. This proactive approach quickly identifies and fixes issues, ensuring database availability. For DevOps teams, this means fewer emergencies, more stable infrastructure, and improved performance. Now let's move on to failover. DevOps teams often grapple with managing ops across multiple locations and cloud providers while ensuring continuity and avoiding disruptions. Cluster Control addresses these challenges by enabling high availability through replication, sharding, and cluster deployments. It supports various infrastructures based on technologies such as VMware, Nutanix, OpenStack, and hyperscalers like AWS, Azure, and GCP, providing flexibility without locking you into specific infrastructure. Additionally, Clustercontrol automates node recovery and failover management, ensuring your databases remain operational during outages or failures with zero downtime. For this part of the demo, we will use the MySQL replication cluster with two database nodes, one primary, writable, and one read-only replica. Before we see auto recovery in action, let's configure Clustercontrol to automatically rebuild a failed node. Ensure that cluster auto recovery and node auto recovery are enabled. Next, in the system settings, search for replication and then set replication auto rebuild slave to 1, which means enabled. The node list and topology view show that node with IP 139.59.145.169. is the primary database instance in this MySQL cluster. To simulate failure, we will now reboot the primary node. Clustercontrol will detect the primary database's failure and automatically initiate a job to promote a replica instance. The failover to a new master is Clustercontrol failing over to the replica node to become the primary. Once the failover is complete, we will see that the replica node becomes the primary. If the failed primary node becomes available, it will be automatically provisioned as a replica within a few seconds, as shown here. Next, let's delve into the backup and recovery features of Clustercontrol, which focuses on ensuring data continuity by performing point-in-time recovery. Managing backups across various service providers can be manual and time-consuming for DevOps teams. Clustercontrol acts as your centralized backup and recovery center for all your open-source databases. Plus, with a single pane of glass, you can view all your backups, regardless of the service or cloud provider you're using. This integral backup solution supports a wide range of recovery scenarios tailored to different database flavors and business needs. For this backup and recovery demo, we will use the Sovereign Galera cluster and navigate to the Backups tab to see all the backups available in this cluster. To start, let's see how easily you can create backups with Clustercontrol. We will click on Create Backup. You will be met with an option to create a backup on demand, which is to create a backup instantly, or to schedule a periodic backup. For this quick demo, we will just create an on-demand backup. Here you see the configuration. You have options to select the node you wish to backup, the backup method and dump type. If you want to upload the backup to the cloud, toggle the option on, and you will see an extra configuration sequence for access to the cloud bucket you want to store your backup on. For this demo, we will be storing the backup on the node. In the advanced settings, we can do a more detailed configuration of the backup, from the retention period to enabling encryption. Configure storage options lets you choose where to store the backup, either on the node or on the controller. For this demo, we will be storing the backup on the node. We can also edit the default storage directory and subdirectory. Next, we can preview the settings, then create the backup, and we can see that the backup creation job will begin. After a few minutes or a few seconds, depending on the amount of data being backed up, you will see that the backup is completed. Moving on, performing point-in-time recovery with Clustercontrol is seamless. Here's how you do it. First, we need to start the process by clicking Restore a Backup. You have two options: restoring from an external or internal backup source. For this demo, we will restore an internal backup. Next, we select the backup. Clustercontrol automatically detects the available backups. Select the backup you want to restore and specify where to restore it from. After that, we need to choose the restore method. In a disaster recovery scenario, where immediate recovery is crucial, select Restore on Node. Then let's enable point-in-time recovery. You can choose the node to restore the backup onto a temporary directory and make a copy of the data tier before restoring the backup. This is useful for postmortem analysis. Next, decide whether to bootstrap the cluster from the restored node. In this scenario, we are performing a full cluster outage recovery and need to configure the recovery. Lastly, we configure recovery options. Choose between time-based or position-based recovery. This decision is based on binary logs to pinpoint the exact position or time of recovery. For this demo, we set it to recover from just before 12 a.m. midnight, the point at which everything went haywire. Initially, only a single primary node of the cluster will be restored. Verify the integrity of the data set, as restoring a non-verified backup may cause server failures and unexpected results. Ensure the backup is verified, then click Continue. Finally, review the summary of the point-in-time recovery backup, and upon clicking Finish, the recovery process will start. We can view the recovery job here on the Jobs tab, and after a few minutes, the backup will be restored. Finally, let's explore how Clustercontrol helps keep your database software up to date and minimizes maintenance overhead. This is crucial for DevOps teams aiming to maintain current database software without interruptions. In any clustered environment, maintaining consistent software versions and tracking all available patches can be a daunting task. Clustercontrol makes great work of this, as you get comprehensive reports on required upgrades and patches for your database infrastructure. It ensures your databases are up to date with the latest features and security patches while maintaining security and compliance, all with minimal downtime. Let's go into this Postgres 14 cluster I created for this demo, then to the Actions menu in the top right. We can see that Clustercontrol gives us an option called Upgrades. Upon clicking it, we will see that Clustercontrol can perform major and minor upgrades to databases and load balancers. For a minor upgrade, first, check for the available package. You can upgrade components one by one, such as starting with HA proxy, and then upgrading the database node. This approach ensures minimal downtime. That's for the minor upgrade. For a major upgrade, you can go to the upgrade section and choose the major upgrade option. You can see that the current version of our Postgres cluster is version 14, and we will upgrade to 15. Clustercontrol supports this process. For example, if you have a Postgres cluster with version 13, you cannot upgrade directly to 15. You need to first upgrade to 14, and then once your database is upgraded to Postgres 14, you can proceed to upgrade to 15. This is how Clustercontrol supports major upgrades. The current upgrade method involves copying data from the existing data directory to another data directory. This copy option will clone your data directory within the existing database server. For the link option method, it creates a hard link from your existing data directory. With the pgdumpall method, it will back up your database, and then, after the database software is upgraded to version 15, Clustercontrol will restore from the backup to your new Postgres 15. You must know that performing a major upgrade is done at your own risk. Therefore, you must check everything first. If you choose to use the pgdumpall method, there's an option to delete your old node. You will also need to define the port, the temporary master port, and the temporary upgrade port. Then, you will see a preview displaying the method, the current version, the upgrade version, the temporary master port, the temporary upgrade candidate port, and the option to delete the old node. After reviewing these details, you just need to submit it. Clustercontrol will create a job to upgrade your existing Postgres 14 to version 15. That's how easy it is to perform both minor and major upgrades in Postgres. It's incredibly simple and easy. No need to SSH into a node to check for updates. You can also schedule updates according to your needs. With Clustercontrol, you can manage everything from a single pane of glass. That concludes this demo. Visit several9s.com/clustercontrol to learn more, or try our Enterprise Edition free for 30 days. Clustercontrol offers 3 plans to fit your needs. You can review the detailed list of features of each plan at several9s.com/pricing. Thanks for watching.